Hi, welcome back to the shop. Thanks for stopping by. This week we are going to participate in the hashtag Dibber event that Steve at SK Krafts in the UK started up a week ago. So I'm going to make two. This is going to be a project that sells video, so I'm going to make one with just regular, you know, regular tools between centers here. Well, they're both going to be made between centers, but I'm going to make one for beginners, and then we're going to make one with the skew, which is what the challenge is. So I'm going to do the first one in regular time, and depending on how long the video is, I may speed up the skew one just for time's sake. So this is just a piece of maple. It's 2 inches by 2 inches by 12 inches long, almost. And so what we want to make is we're going to make what a dibber is, I guess I should explain. A dibber is what you use in the spring or fall to plant bulbs in your flower garden. So it'll have a tapered bottom on it with lines at every inch, up to 6 inches, so you know how deep you are, with a handle. All right, so we're gonna round this up with a spindle roughing gouge, and then we're gonna work with a spindle gouge after that. This is turning at 1900 RPM. I'm gonna put some links in the description of a few of my friends over in the UK who are doing these things this week as well. I'll put in SK Krafts, who came up with the idea for Dibber Week, and TJTurning from Terry Bray, and Brian at Heartwood Turning, and Pete at Pete's Twisted Trees, and Mark, the gentleman woodturner. I'll have those links in the description. So if you want to see a few different methods and a few different styles of these things, you can check those guys out. And if you haven't seen their stuff, take a peek and give them a sub. Make sure that I got enough. I got 6 inches here. I'm gonna bring this down just a little more, maybe it's a little big. Thank you. that down a little bit both ways. The lines out now. This up with 180 grit paper. All right, so now we're just gonna lay out the 1-inch marks. And this is just so you can see what depth you're planning at. You can take a skew or a diamond tool, whichever you choose, and just put a little notch in each one of these lines. Very carefully. Alright, so I sanded that up, started at 180 and just did 180 and 240. That's plenty smooth for this. Now, I'm just going to put some hot wax on this. Now I'm just going to burn in these lines so that they're easier to see when someone's using it. And this is, you can make the handle whatever shape is comfortable for you, or, you know, or there's no set in stone anything. Just 6 inches is a good length to have here because that covers most bulbs. And then just any handle, and you can make it out of any kind of scrap wood you've got. So I'm just going to take this piece of maple and burn this. Make sure you have your shavings cleaned up when you're doing this, in case an ember drops. If you wanted to take this down smaller at both ends with a skewer or another tool, you could. I'm just going to sand them off and round them up. And that's really all you need to do. So the next one, you'll see that I do part them down quite a bit closer with the skew. So that's all there is to that. So very simple, like I said, scrap wood, anything you want to use, really any design you want to make them. You use probably between $15 and $20 selling. So a great little project, doesn't take very long. It's pretty easy to do, you know, 4 or 5 in an hour. If you're just playing away at it. All right, so we're going to take this one off. I'm going to sand these up and bring you back when we do one with a skew.
I'll put a picture up at the end of the finished two pieces, and I'll sand up the first piece here at the end of the video to show you how we finished off the ends. If you're still with me, thanks for sticking around. I really appreciate it. Thanks again to everyone who watches the videos and subscribe to the channel. I appreciate that a ton as well. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you didn't, give it a thumbs down. And please do leave a comment and share if you wouldn't mind. That would help to grow my channel a ton. And we will see you next time.